Hello, this is Mario from ODEON. In this video, we will talk about drawing 3D models and importing them into ODEON. If you are watching our playlist on getting started with ODEON, or if you are trying the free demo version, know that ODEON includes several pre-installed rooms. So, if you prefer to get familiar with ODEON before using your own models, you can follow our series of tutorial videos using the pre-installed rooms. If you do wish to start using your own rooms, there are certain considerations that need to be taken into account. First off, ODEON is mainly a room acoustic simulation software, but does not include a lot of 3D drawing tools. Drawing the 3D geometry should mostly be done in an external CAD software. Then, you import the model into ODEON, where you can configure sources, receivers, and materials, and perform calculations. ODEON is compatible with various geometry formats, such as DXF, DWG, and more recently, IFC BIM files. For IFC, ODEON accepts files specifically from Revit and ArchiCAD. Additional to these formats, you can also export SketchUp files directly from SketchUp into ODEON via a plugin. Before we talk about how to import the models, we will give some guidelines for 3D models that can be used in ODEON. ODEON is mainly recommended for medium to large sized rooms, such as classrooms, restaurants, offices, industrial halls, concert halls, and cathedrals. ODEON's energy-based calculation methods do not take phase information into account, so details like resonant modes will not be calculated. Therefore, ODEON works best in cases with high modal overlap. In small rooms, there might be prominent modes at low frequencies, so results at those frequencies may not be reliable. A good rule of thumb for reliability is to look at results above the room's Schroeder frequency. You can read about this in our user manual, which you can access from within ODEON by going to the Help menu, User's Manual. Then, go to section 9.1. One case of small rooms that can be calculated in ODEON are small engine rooms. Due to the number of sources and their spectra in this type of room, the sound field is quite diffuse, and therefore can be calculated reliably in ODEON. Additionally, keep in mind that in ODEON, you can also make simulations in an outdoor model, such as this oil rig. The most important thing to keep in mind when making a room model for acoustic simulations in ODEON is that the room model should not be highly detailed. For example, here, there is excessive detail on the window frames. And this column is made of two small surfaces. A high level of detail can actually negatively affect the accuracy of calculations. This is because the calculation methods in ODEON require some geometrical assumptions. Specifically, surfaces should be of a considerable size. At very small surfaces, these assumptions are violated. Additionally, an excessive amount of detail can slow down the interface and makes it harder to work with the model. So, a highly detailed 3D model for architectural or visual purposes will typically not be usable for acoustic simulations in ODEON. Some of the smallest surfaces you could have in a model are the seat and backrest of a chair, in a very simplified way. Any detail smaller than this should likely be simplified or not included in the model. Some examples of details that should be simplified as a flat surface are the individual bricks on a wall, a bookshelf, and the audience area in a concert hall. To compensate for the complex reflections from these surfaces, a scattering coefficient is assigned to them in ODEON. For an example of this, try opening the room called Elmia Round Robin 2 Detailed. You will see that the audience area has been modeled as a flat surface, and this is actually best practice for acoustic simulations in ODEON. You can see that a considerably high scattering coefficient has been assigned to the audience area surfaces. This will be explained in our tutorial on setting absorption and scattering. Railings, especially those with thick elements, are also typically modeled as a single flat surface. And later, you can assign a transparency coefficient, which expresses the percentage of rays that go through the surface. If the railing elements are very thin, you can just not include the railing in the model. Curved surfaces with a high polygon count should also be avoided. If you have columns, arches, or domes, they should be modeled with a series of flat surfaces in increments of 10 to 30 degrees. Try to avoid warped surfaces as much as possible. In architectural models, windows are often modeled as holes for visibility. But in ODEON, windows should be defined as a surface, in order to be able to assign absorption and transmission. This is the case even for open windows, where you should assign 100% absorption. If your CAD software supports grouping surfaces by layers or tags, we highly recommend to do it, as this greatly simplifies the acoustic simulation setup later in ODEON. If you have a complicated model with multiple rooms, but the rooms are uncoupled or only connected by narrow entrances, you should try to split the model into independent submodels. In this way, handling the models will be easier and calculations will be more manageable. Geometries for use in ODEON should also be as close to 100% watertight as possible. Otherwise, rays may escape from the model, which can cause problems during the calculation. But as long as the percentage of escaping rays is minimal, the model can still be used. Now, let's import a geometry. If you're using SketchUp, this is done through our SketchUp to ODEON plugin. Installing and using the plugin is explained in another video. Additionally, if you currently don't have a preferred CAD software, we can recommend SketchUp, since it is fairly easy to learn, and you can export the geometries with our plugin. But for now, we will assume that your model is in any of these formats. Again, for IFC files, only those from Revit and ArchiCAD can currently be imported. They must also be set up and exported in a certain way to make them compatible with ODEON, which is explained in Chapter 2.7 of our user manual. Here, find the section corresponding to your CAD software. After you select the file, you choose the folder and file name of the new ODEON model. I will only mention a few of the options here. Glue surfaces simplifies walls made of many surfaces into a single surface, which we highly recommend to keep enabled. Points separated by a distance smaller than this maximum point margin will be simplified to a single point. And surfaces with an amount of warp exceeding this maximum warp will be split into separate surfaces. These buttons suggest different tolerance numbers. We recommend to experiment with these tolerances to find the optimal import settings. You can read about all the options here by pressing F1 in this window, which opens the context-sensitive help for the currently active window. Once you accept the settings, you can also select which layers to import. This is one of the places where having layers in your model is useful. In the case of IFC files, ODEON can further simplify by identifying irrelevant surfaces in the BIM information and discarding them, such as the terrain outside the building. With all of ODEON's simplification tools, this IFC file was reduced from over 278,000 surfaces to only 646. With that, we conclude this tutorial, and we hope you have found it useful. Good luck!